The low-swirl burner actually was first developed as a tool to study flame turbulence interaction. The benefit of the low-swirl burner is, number one, it can support a very wide range of operating conditions. The flame does not grow much in size as we increase the heat release and increase the velocity. For us in the laboratory, that's a huge benefit because this burner allows us to run experiment at a very wide range of conditions without the need to reposition our laser diagnostics and our sensors. So if we can capture that natural propagating nature of a flame, the flame would become very stable even at the very lean conditions. And this is what our technology offers. But because of the success in our development of the swirler and the performance, we started working with a company called Maxon. And right now they have two lines of products for heating, drying. The interesting aspect that they told me was that even though it's an ultra-low emission burner, they are able to find market for this burner in places that does not require low emissions burner because in the absence of pollutants, for example, they sell the burner to commercial baking. So without any pollution, all the chicken meat comes out whiter. And that's a desirable feature that they've been able to find customer. What I'm working on right now is trying to develop this technology for a much, much larger gas turbine. But we still don't understand what is the underlying physics that controlling that scaling. So I am working with a mathematician at LBNL who perform simulation using supercomputers. And so I believe for us to answer that question of scaling, but I think simulation can help answer that question.